Okay, let's look at the data and compare the two distributions. The population mean, in other words, the average number of blue M&Ms across all of our bags, was 11.25. The expected value, in other words, the mean of all the means we took from our 50 random samples, was 11.08. Notice, those are pretty close. They're not exactly the same, but they're not far off. The population standard deviation for all 48 plates, or bags, was 3.49.
Hi, it's me again. Let's recap Professor Rogers and Professor Laraway's experiment and then predict what happened before they tell us their results. So they took a bag of M&Ms and they calculated the number of blue M&Ms in that bag. So this is the first bag and they put it on a plate labeled plate number one. And N1 represents the number of blue M&Ms in that bag, or now on that plate. And they did that with a second bag and counted the number of blue M&Ms. And they did that up to number 48. So they have 48 bags, and they dumped each bag onto one plate. So here's our population, the number of blue M&Ms on each plate. They found that the mean is 11.25 blue M&Ms, and the standard deviation is 3.49. From this population, Professors Laraway and Rogers randomly selected 5 plates. And then they counted the number of blue M&Ms, divided by 5, and got the average number of blue M&Ms. And then they did this 50 times! Can you believe it? So then they got 50 sample means. So now let's take a quick quiz. According to the central limit theorem, approximately what should be the mean and standard deviation of this distribution of sample means? So write your answer here. When you calculate these, remember you're calculating the theoretical probability, which is based on using every possible sample of size 5 from this population. But here they're using only 50 samples of size 5. There are a lot more, but we can't expect Professors Rogers and Laraway to do that. That would really take forever. So calculate the theoretical mean and standard error based on the central limit theorem.